agenda items. Pursuant to the codified ordinances of Jackson County, section 213.06, members of the public may address any item that is not on the agenda. However, pursuant to ORS 192.640, the Board of Commissioners is prohibited from discussing a principal subject that is not on the agenda. We generally hold these comments to 5 minutes. So with that, the invitation is open for anybody who wants to address the Board of Commissioners this morning. Please come up, identify yourself for the record. Come on up, Kurt. Good morning.
Good morning. Kurt Chancellor, Central Point. I didn't know. I asked a question last week about our process. I don't know if somebody wanted to answer that or if they had an answer for me.
No, I apologize. I was going to ask counsel to respond to you formally in some sort of a letter or something like that. You can refer to the charter, of course, as well, which is online. But I was going to ask counsel if he would reply.
Yeah, the charter, it just said that you guys served all functions.
Correct.
You know, and I was just curious, you know, how that worked, since everything that I read says, you know, no, but what do I know? That's why I'm asking. Well, thank you, gentlemen. I'll wait for your answer.
Okay, counsel, Mr. Chair, if you don't mind, I haven't done any research regarding this, but I did do some thinking about it after you prodded my curiosity last week as well. And I think what you cited were provisions from the U.S. Constitution and the state constitution. And in each of those documents, those constitutions, there are specific references to the three branches of government, executive, judicial, and legislative. The Constitution, as it were, for Jackson County is the county charter, so that is the voter-approved constitution for this community, and it just doesn't have that type of three branches of government set forth in the charter. So it was the choice of the citizens in approving the county charter not to set it up that way, which is why there is no equivalent in the county charter to a president of the United States or the governor of the state of Oregon. So that would be the executive branch function, which is not specifically provided for in our charter. So the executive functions do need to be handled by every government. And in other local governments, you know, sometimes the mayor serves that function in local governments. Multnomah County, for example, that's the type of setup that they have. And the county commissioners there are actually department heads, and they perform the council members, they actually perform the duties of the executive branch by overseeing specific departments within Multnomah County government. So the short story or short answer to your question is that the Jackson County form of government, the charter, which is the Jackson County Constitution, simply doesn't have that type of setup for our local government. In addition, there's no court specifically mentioned in the Jackson County Charter. The state statutes do, of course, allow for a justice court, and that has been established. So that's effectively the judicial piece of county government, an elected justice of the peace. And finally, you mentioned quasi-judicial. You know, I'd point out that a lot of those duties are driven by state law. If you think about land use matters, it's kind of the state law that creates that quasi-judicial land use system. I know you take issue with that, and I don't want to argue that particular thing, but that's one of the reasons why there are some quasi-judicial functions in the Board of Commissioners, is because it's mandated by state law. And in that regard, I'd also point out that the board has, I think, made some effort to separate those quasi-judicial functions from their legislative and executive functions by appointing hearings officers, which at least, if you may not agree with the system that's in place, it at least separates to some extent the political leaders from that quasi-judicial function. So that's my response. In short, again, the Jackson County Constitution, which is our voter-approved charter, just doesn't have that same form of government mandated for Jackson County government.
So our charter, as a home rule charter, gives the counties that have taken this type of government the authority to create their own constitution that in many ways can circumvent the other two, the state and federal.
Well, I wouldn't call it circumvention. I certainly wouldn't use that word. It's simply a choice of the local voters who give their power to the Board of Commissioners through the county charter mechanism. So I wouldn't call it circumvention. It's a choice that voters made.
All right. Well, that gives me a lot to think about and research. Thank you for your time.
Okay, Kurt, thank you.
Thank you for indulging me, Mr.
Chair. You bet. Okay.